Yes, ma'am. I made you the host. We can start the lecture.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Good evening, everyone present here. Good evening. I hope all of you are doing well. All right. Since sir was not available today, I am covering up for him. I hope you guys don't mind. All right. Yeah. So if you have any sort of doubts or you want to ask me anything, you can message me in the account of Rajvi Thakkar. All right. If you want to tell anything, you can message me in the other account. All right. Very quickly, today we are going to begin with a grammar topic. All right. So I hope you guys are ready. Yes, what doubt do you have? Who is this Saitham? Okay. Not available now. All right. Can you see my screen now? Okay, let us begin with the grammar topic clauses. Now it is supposedly a very difficult topic for you guys to understand, and you know you tend to make a lot of mistakes here. All right, so in this lecture we are going to brush up the basics of clauses, and if you pay attention in this lecture, I guarantee you that you will understand. And you will clear all the basic doubts that you have. Okay. Okay. Somebody has this doubt, so I'm just cutting off in between. Past progressive tense is nothing but past continuous tense, the action which was going on in the past at the time of speaking. Okay. So I was eating a cake. So was eating is past progressive tense. All right. Come on. Now back to clauses. Yeah. So before learning the actual clauses, and you know, you have so many types of clauses. First, let us clear the two basic parts that we have. Okay. We have already done the topic of finite and non-finite verbs. All right. We will revise that. And then we will move on to see the definition of sentence, phrase, and clause. All right. So very quickly, guys, tell me what are finite and non-finite verbs. Come on. Who can tell me? We are brushing up the topics, okay? We are brushing up something which is very, very essential to understand what clauses are. All right. So I want all of you to give me answers. Okay, we have two types of verbs. One is finite, the other is non-finite. Can somebody explain me what the difference is? Very good, Nishita from JB Nagar. Very good. She said that there is subject before verb, usko finite verb bolte hai. Very good. Okay, let us see. Finite verbs and non-finite verbs. Let us see this with an example. Finite verbs, subject is present or possible before the verb. Vedika from DN Nagar, very good. Finite verb shows tense and non-finite verb does not show the tense. Very, very good. That is the first and a very important point of differentiation between them. फाइनाइट वर्ब इज अ वर्ब दैट शोज यू द टेंस, टाइमिंग दिखाता है एक्शन कब हुआ था, ठीक है. नॉन फाइनाइट वर्ब विल नॉट शो यू द टेंस, विल नॉट शो यू द टाइम ऑफ द एक्शन. ओके, टू हैव इट सिंप्लीफाइड फॉर यू गाइज, फाइनाइट वर्ब्स देयर सब्जेक्ट, प्रेजेंट और पॉसिबल. वॉट इज सब्जेक्ट नाउ? सब्जेक्ट इज एनी नाउन और प्रोनाउन बिफोर द वर्ब. All right. So here the subject is either present or it is possible to put a subject just before the verb. All right. Non-finite verbs mein subject mushkil hi nahi, namumkin hota hai. Theek hai? So there is no subject possible before the verb. All right. Come on. Dhruv laughed and jumped. Okay. Let us see this one. Dhruv laughed and jumped. Can somebody show me the verbs in this sentence? Very good. Laughed and jumped. Both are two different verbs. Very good. Laughed, one. Jumped, second. Okay. Now, how to determine if those are finite or non-finite? Let us see the first one. Laughed. जो वर्ब है उसके एग्जैक्टली पहले देयर इज ध्रुव. ध्रुव इज अ सब्जेक्ट, करेक्ट. सो दैट बिकम्स माय फाइनाइट वर्ब बिकॉज सब्जेक्ट इज प्रेजेंट बिफोर द वर्ब, एग्जैक्टली बिफोर द वर्ब. वेरी क्लियर विद दिस? ओके, व्हाट अबाउट द अदर वर्ब जंप्ड? कैन somebody टेल मी द आंसर? It is non-finite, all right. Tell me why. Tell me why. Is subject present before it? Jumped ke pehle kaun sa word hai? It is and, correct? Which is a conjunction. So clearly there is no subject present before it. Okay, can we write, can we add a subject and see for ourselves? Can we do that? So can I write the sentence as Dhruv laughed and he jumped, or Dhruv laughed and Dhruv jumped? Is it correct? Is it making sense? Yes, it is. Therefore, the word which is there in the bracket, ye beta jo hai na, subject possible before the verb. Subject, either it can be present or it could be possible to put a subject. All right. So Dhruv laughed and jumped. Jumped is also a finite verb. Jumped is also a finite verb. All right. Let us look at another example, the second example. While running, he fell. Can you please pick out the verbs? Very good. Running, comma, fell. Very good. Both of these are the verbs in this sentence. Excellent. Now let us focus on running first. While running. So running. Is a running finite or a non-finite verb? Let us look at the word which is before it. Okay. Running ke pehle while hai. While is a conjunction again. Can we put while Dhruv running, he fell? Is it making sense? While Dhruv running, he fell. No. Haan, agar aisa hota, while he was running, while Dhruv was running. But was is not there. It's not present, correct? So running as such is not showing me the time. Okay, the tense of the verb, all right. Therefore, running becomes your non-finite verb. Whereas fell, the exact word before fell is he. Now, he is a subject, correct? It is a pronoun. It is a subject. And if subject is present, before the verb, it becomes your finite verb. Okay. Fell, it is showing me simple past tense. Guys, are we very, very clear with this one? All right. So to sum it up again, guys, very quickly. Finite verbs के पहले subject होता है, अगर नहीं होता है तो possible तो होता है, it is not impossible. जो verbs होते हैं जिनके पहले exactly before it subject डालना मुश्किल ही नहीं नामुमकिन होता है, वो आपके non-finite verbs हुए. Very very clear with this, guys? Okay, yeah. Moving on. Yeah, moving on. So this was your part one of your division. Okay. Now, guys, who can tell me what is a sentence? Your definition, whatever you know. You're dealing with sentences since like 8 years now. Come on, tell me. Okay, very good. A group of words that make a meaning, a group of words that makes sense. It is a group of words, a bunch of something, I don't know what. Okay. Not bad, guys. Very, very good explanation. A bunch of words, all right. Okay. Let us see. A sentence is a group of words that makes complete sense. Very, very important part. It is a group of words that makes complete sense. A sentence is a group of words that are put together to mean something. So it is completely meaningful. You will not have questions at the end of it. Okay. Let us look at some examples. Pankaj eats sweets. I completely understand what this group of words is trying to tell me. All right. Does Pankaj eat sweets? Please get me some water. What a beautiful painting it is. Okay, what do you observe here? All the kinds of sentences are there, correct? We have assertive sentences, interrogative sentences, exclamatory sentences, imperative sentences, correct? So all of these words, group of words, they mean something, okay? And when they are put together, we call it a sentence, okay? These are different types of sentences. Now, let us, you just had to just understand and revise. You don't need to write here. Okay, moving on. What is a phrase? Come on, give me the definition of phrase. Sentence, phrase. What is a phrase? Okay, it is an incomplete sentence which does not make any sense. Okay. Okay. Unmeaning sense. Okay. I don't know what that means. Yes, guys. Very good, very good. A group of words which do not make a complete sense. It is an incomplete sentence. Maybe you can put it like that. Not really. All right. Let us see. A phrase is a group of words that adds meaning to the sentence. A phrase is not a sentence because it is not a complete idea. Okay, so in simpler words, I could tell you, please listen to this attentively. A phrase is a group of words, okay, it is a group of words that means something, okay, that has some meaning. But not complete meaning. It does not have a complete sense. All right. So a phrase is a group of words without a complete meaning. Very, very clear with this one? Let us look at the examples. All my dear children, so very sweet, very happy with his work. But who is very happy? What is, you know, some, there is no head or tail here. There is some words where you know what it is, you know, all my dear children. But what for them? Okay. So it's not meaningless, guys. It means something, but it does not have a complete sense. Very clear with this. Now we move on to the main part that we are going to study now. What are clauses? What is a clause? Very important to understand this one. What is a clause? You may know the types, but it is very, very important to know the definition of it. Very good, Nishita. Very good. Your answer is correct. There is this one simple, very simple definition of clause. It means that it is, so it is a group of words containing one finite verb. Okay, forget about everything else. Clause is a group of words containing one finite verb. Okay, matlab uska sense banta hai nahi banta does not matter. It is a group of words which has one finite verb in it. Are we very, very, very clear here? Yes or no, guys? It is a group of words containing one finite verb. All right. Okay. So, come on. I'll give you a simple example. Tell me if it is a clause or not. She fell. Is it a clause? She fell. Yes, it is a clause. Why? Since it has a finite verb in it. Very, very clear with this? Okay, come on. Here is the book. Here is the book. Now, can you tell me the finite verb in this sentence? Very good. Is. Very good. Next. Now look at it independently. Which is placed on the table? Which is placed on the table is another clause. Why? Because is the finite verb here, correct? All right. Very clear with this. Is placed is another finite verb. Now, how to identify? Sorry. How many clauses are there, guys? How many clauses are there? Two or three? Many. Okay. I want a number from you guys. Two. Wrong. Two is the correct answer. There are two clauses. We have main clause and subordinate clause. ऑल राइट, मेन एंड सबॉर्डिनेट क्लॉज. बाकी जो सारे होते हैं वो टाइप्स होते हैं, वो आगे जाके पढ़ते हैं. सबसे पहले द टू क्लॉजेस, मेन क्लॉज एंड सबॉर्डिनेट क्लॉज. नाउ व्हाट आर द फंक्शंस ऑफ मेन क्लॉज एंड सबॉर्डिनेट क्लॉज, लेट अस लुक एट दिस. मेन क्लॉज का दूसरा नाम होता है इंडिपेंडेंट क्लॉज. ओके, मेन क्लॉज इज नथिंग बट इंडिपेंडेंट क्लॉज. इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड प्रिंसिपल क्लॉज. It is also called principal clause. So main clause or independent clause will function on its own. It does not depend on any other clause or words for its meaning. Whereas a subordinate clause is also called dependent clause. Okay, subordinate clause ka dusra naam hai dependent clause. This dependent clause means obviously it depends on the main clause for its meaning. Very clear with this, guys? Okay, so now our aim is to how to identify main clause and subordinate clause. Are we guys clear to here? Okay, so the first thing is, step one, identify the two finite verbs in your sentence. Okay, you have to identify the two finite verbs. Step two, identify the subordinators. All right, first you have to identify two finite verbs, then you have to go and identify a subordinator which will be there. Now, what is a subordinator? What do you mean by a subordinator? Guys, what do you mean by a subordinator? A subordinator is a type of conjunction. All right. Let us see this. So this is a very funny acronym to remember it. Why this kolavariti? Okay. Now, how to remember this? Please pay attention here. WHTHCORT. Now, WH से सारे जो WH वाले conjunctions होते हैं, where, how, what, whatever, when, where, why, who, whom, whose. All of these words are your WH conjunctions. All your WH words. What, when, where, why, who, whom, whose, when, whatever. All of these words. Okay. Next. TH says all the TH conjunctions, that, so that, than, more than, though, although, even though, as though. All of these words are your TH conjunctions. CO meaning condition. Condition conjunctions are the conjunctions where those words are typically used to express some condition. Okay. You will get a mobile phone if you pass the examination. So if there's a condition here, if you pass the examination. So if, unless, whether, okay? Had is not very frequently and usually used. So if you just can skip that, it's okay. But these three words are very important. If, unless, whether. Provided is also used at times, right? Next. Reason conjunction. R says reason. Since, as, because. You can remember it as sub TV. S-A-B. Since, as, because. Very clear with this. Reason. Why? So the answer is since, as, and because. Next. T says all the time conjunctions. Okay. So any words, all the words that indicate time. When, before, after, till, until, since, once, all of these words are your time conjunctions. So I hope you guys are clear with this. We are doing step one, how to identify, how to separate the main clause and the subordinate clause. First, you are going to identify the two finite verbs that we have done at the beginning of this lecture. Okay, you are identifying the two finite verbs. Then the subordinators, you have to identify the subordinator. Now, when you are going to separate it, step three, separate the main clause and the subordinate clause. Now, it's a very, very, very simple thing. Subordinate clause begins with a subordinator. Subordinate clause begins with a subordinator. Very clear with this? Now let us see this. Subordinate clause starts with a subordinator and ends at the end of the sentence or immediately before the second finite verb. You do not need to understand the second part of the sentence here. All right. Okay. Now there are three types in which your main and subordinate clause are placed. Listen to this very properly. There are three ways in which your main and subordinate clauses are placed. The first one is main clause aage aata hai, subordinate clause uske peeche aata hai, jo bahut typically, you know, it is like that, okay? Main clause and then the subordinate clause. Sometimes it is ulta, okay? Subordinate clause plus main clause. Sometimes there is a vada pav clause, okay? Main clause aju baju, beech mein subordinate clause. All right? So this vada pav clause, aage peeche main clause, beech mein subordinate clause. All right? Very, very clear till here? Okay. Let us look at the first example. I hope that India wins the World Cup. Now, first of all, guys, I want you to identify the two verbs in this sentence. Come on, quickly. Very good. Hope and wins. Hope and wins. What is the second step now? Okay, yes, definitely both are finite verbs. Hope ke exactly pehle I hai. Wins ke exactly pehle India hai. Theek hai? Now, identify the subordinator, that is your step two. Very good. The subordinator is that. Okay. So your subordinate clause begins with subordinator. Correct. Your subordinate clause begins with a subordinator. The subordinator is very, very easy. It is that. Iska matlab hua, I hope is main clause. That India wins the World Cup is subordinate clause. All right. Okay, at the end of your answer, you just have to understand and see, check if both these clauses, the main clause and the subordinate clause, should have its own personal finite verb. All right. So I hope. Main clause that India wins the World Cup is your subordinate clause. Guys, are we very, very clear on this one? Do you have any doubts? No. All right. So moving on, let us see another Okay. Second one. Where Sita went was a mystery. Where Sita went was a mystery. Come on, guys, very quickly give me the finite verbs in this sentence. Very good. Went and was. Very good. Went and was. It's wrong here. There's a mistake here. Okay. Went is the finite verb. Very clear with this? Okay. So we have done with the first part. What is the second part? Subordinator. Pick out the subordinator in this sentence. Subordinator is where. Very good. So where is your subordinator? It is your subordinator. Okay. Now you know that, guys, listen to this very properly. You know that subordinate clause begins with a subordinator. So subordinator is at the beginning of the sentence. Therefore, this entire thing will be a subordinate clause till this part. Why am I breaking the sentence here? Is because I want both the main. Sorry, I want both the finite verbs to be there in different clauses. Okay, I want my main clause to have one finite verb. And I want the subordinate clause to have a finite verb. All right. So went or was ke beech mein if I break it up, to kya hoga? Ki subordinate clause ke paas ek apna finite verb hoga, main clause ke paas bhi ek finite verb hoga. All right. So where Sita went is subordinate clause. Was a mystery is main clause. Now, ideally, the sentence should have been, it was a mystery where Sita went. All right. So the answer is, it was a mystery. It is in the bracket because although it is not there in the sentence, it is to be understood. All right. It was a mystery main clause. Where Sita went subordinate clause. So this is a perfect example of how subordinate clause is at the beginning and it is followed by main clause. All right, guys, any doubts here? All right, let us go with the third type of the placement of the main clause and the subordinate clause. Let's see it. The movie that we saw was fantastic. The movie that we saw was fantastic. Please give me the two finite verbs here. Very good. Saw and was. Saw and was. Very good. Both of these are finite verbs. Correct. Okay. Which is the subordinator in this sentence? Subordinator. Very good. It is that. So we know that subordinate clause is going to begin with that because it is subordinate term. Correct? Okay. So here, from here, I will begin my subordinate clause. The issue here is the movie main clause aa sakta hai? The movie, sirf the movie. Can that be my main clause? No. Why? Why? Here, actually, guys, the ideal answer should be the movie main clause that we saw was fantastic, subordinate clause. Is this answer correct or not? Yes, very good, very good. The point here is, agar main the movie ko finite, agar main the movie ko मेन क्लॉज बताती हूँ तो ये रॉन्ग हो गया बिकॉज मेन क्लॉज शुड हैव अ फाइनाइट वर्ब. द मूवी is a subject, it does not have any verb, it does not have a finite verb. What do I need to do, guys, is that I need to give a finite verb. Okay, can I do something like this? Okay, saw or was ke beech mein I have taken this break. Okay, and jo second verb hai na, second verb I will give it to the main clause, give it to the main clause. Now the movie was fantastic. Now does it sound like a complete sentence? Yes or no? Yes, it sounds like a complete sentence. The movie was fantastic that we saw. It is subordinate clause. Very clear with this? See guys, I need you to understand why are we breaking things up in between and why there is this vada pav clause here. All right, because my main clause did not have a finite verb, it does not become a main clause. All right, so the movie was fantastic main clause. Where Sita went, are baba wrong hai. You guys know the correct answer, that we saw this one. Okay, that we saw subordinate clause. All right, any doubts till here? Okay, so step 1, identify the two finite verbs. Step 3, step 2, identify the subordinator. Step 3, separate the main clause and subordinate clause such that subordinate clause begins with subordinator and main clause as well as subordinate clause has their own finite verbs. All right, now moving on, we have 3 types of subordinate clauses. How many types of clauses are there? 2, main and subordinate. अभी हम लोग क्या करने वाले हैं? Subordinate clause has 3 types. All right, there are 3 types of subordinate clause depending upon the function that they serve. Okay, main clause के कोई functions नहीं होते, subordinate clause के function होते हैं. Subordinate clause के function होते हैं. Okay, so therefore it is subordinate noun, subordinate adjective and subordinate adverb clause. Okay, so types of subordinate clause, the first one is noun. Then we have adjective and then we have adverb. Okay, and I want you to understand it in the way that I have written. All right, whenever you have to look for the type of subordinate clause, first you will have to check for noun clause. If it is not a subordinate noun clause, you will check if it is a subordinate adjective clause. Agar ye dono mein se koi nahi hai, then you will see which type of subordinate adverb clause you have. Am I very very clear here? Okay, so we have noun, adjective and adverb. Noun, adjective and adverb. Okay, so I guess we are only going to understand till here. Okay, do you have any doubts? Okay, the types of the subordinate clauses will be done in the next lecture. All right, okay, and before moving on, always remember this and note it down somewhere. To identify the type of the subordinate clause, always ask the question to the main clause. The answer should be given by the subordinate clause. Always remember this, note it down. You will understand what I'm telling right now in the next lecture. So just note it down somewhere. ask the question to the main clause, answer will be given by subordinate clause. All right. So here we finished the lecture. I hope everybody has understood everything. We have cleared up the basics. So now you will have no issues in understanding clauses. It is really very, very simple. For the next lecture, just do one thing. Please revise whatever we have done in this class. I repeat, please revise whatever we have done in this class so that you will be able to understand the next lecture very, very well. All right. Thank you so much, everyone. Thank you. Bye. Take care and stay safe.